Good morning, everyone. It's kind of an interesting show I got today. Yeah, stay tuned. We're giving something away. In the meantime, we need to get into this. This is just a snippet of things I have drawn up and created on a 3D printer. I think if you're determined to, you know, do anything with 3D printing, the big thing you're going to have to do is learn CAD, which is a software program that allows you to draw what you're thinking and manufacture something on the 3D printer. It's a big step, but it doesn't have to be that bad. Learning can be, well, can be fun, but it can be so rewarding. And everybody always tells me the rewarding thing, you know, and it's like, it is, you know, it's just, it's like, you just get amazed at yourself when you make something and you see it in front of you and it works. And it's like, it's exactly what I, you know, thought up. And it's like, wow, you know, of course you'll need a piece of paper, a pencil, and a set of calipers generally to measure something up that you're going to try to create or manufacture or just make for something that makes your life better at home. And the CAD programs out there, there is a lot of CAD programs out there, and they're all hard to learn, all of them. But the beast sometimes is called AutoDesk Fusion 360. Yes, it is the beast. It's a hard one to learn. Very steep learning curve, so they tell me. Now, if this old fart can learn it, I think anybody should be able to do it with a little bit of determination of, you know what, I want to learn how to do this so that I can produce the parts I want and the pieces that I need for whatever it is you're working on. And it doesn't have to be craft stuff or artsy or something. It can be mechanical in nature, you know, this sort of thing. This actually plugs into a 3/8 drive tool to allow for finger spinning a socket, you know, that kind of thing. It's just tools around you, and the things you can manufacture out of your own, you know, mind is just, it's just amazing. But you've got to learn a CAD program. It's just, it's part of that step. And I think that there's been a lot, I've seen a lot of different things out there that try to help you learn Fusion 360, but this one came along and it was, it just knocked it out of the park for me. It was like, oh man, this is exactly what somebody needs to do to go down that road and learn that CAD program. And that's a book. It doesn't even say, you know, it's Mastering AutoDesk Fusion. Yes. Yeah, this book is just, I went through the pages to page to the chapters and it was like, this thing is exactly what's needed. Also, I'm going to provide a link in the description below for where you can find this book, but also they have, these guys that put the book out have a master class if you really want to be, you know, a mechanical engineer, you know, or at least learn it. It doesn't hurt, you know. You can actually sign up for the master class and it will take you step by step through and you will be able to produce mega parts of whatever it is you need or want, you know. Yeah, and it's just, it's an amazing class that actually for the price, I think it's a very fair price. So I'm not gonna say too much more about that. The book is actually a really good price too. But the book is great because it starts out with 27 in this case, but step-by-step 3D modeling, you know, and projects for the 3D printer. So you can, you know, out of the book, you can manufacture something. So you will learn and acquire skills that you never had before. And it's, a lot of that is too, is the skill set. Man, once you learn CAD, and if you have a 3D printer, you're a friggin' weapon, okay? Yeah. And so prototyping and manufacturing and making up stuff is just, it is an ungodly feeling. It just opens up the door to so many possibilities. So CAD, drawing up stuff to make on 3D printers is cool. Now, the very first thing you probably should do, besides getting this book, is to download the program. It's free, you know. It's limited when it's the free version. It's a non-commercial license. And it'll allow you to save up to 10 projects at any time. You can't keep more than 10 on the system. And also, you need to make less than $1,000 a year selling your wares or whatever that you're making from your 3D printer at that point. That's the agreement. You know, it's not that bad at all, really. Now, they did have a half price deal this past weekend, which was, I think, a Labor Day sale or something like that going on with Fusion 360 for a subscription fee. It's expensive, so, you know, don't fret over that. Just use the free one for the time being until maybe if you get up on your feet and you're making enough money, hey, take out the subscription. Yeah, absolutely, you know, if you can. It is an awesome powerful program. So what next thing we want to do, of course, once we have the program installed on our computers, we're going to want to look at this book, because this book is not only sets you step by step, but also at the back of each chapter, let's just see if I can find one here. At the end of each chapter, there's some questionnaires to make you see, you know, test yourself to see if you've learned the material that you really need to know in order to use Fusion 360. Now, page to page, you'll see fantastic, you know, diagrams. So it's not a lot of reading. There's a lot of diagrams in here and some reading, of course, a little bit to instruct you, to help you understand, you know, page to page, project to project, where you're going with Fusion 360. And this is all to help you with that learning curve, so you can get into there, into this program, and then you can get, you know, going on Fusion. Because once you have Fusion under your belt, man, the world is your oyster. Yeah, you can design and draw stuff up and manufacture it on a 3D printer and go, wow, I made that. You know? So another point here, the fellas that wrote the book, these two characters went to Mechanical Engineering University and had to take CAD. And they felt that there had to be a better solution to teaching CAD, because CAD is a software that, you know, and drawing that can really achieve a lot of fantastic results, but it is like the drafting of something that's going to become the real thing. And that's why it's it's an important step. If you're going to run a 3D printer and you're really going to do anything serious with it, you need to learn CAD. And this is probably one of the best ways to go, is to get a book like this, get the Fusion 360 in the machine, and start learning how to draw up whatever it is you want to make on your 3D printer. It's just simple. Yeah, it's a no-brainer. But you've got to be determined and understand that it's steps. With, you know, something like CAD, you don't just throw yourself in and say, okay, boom, tomorrow morning I will wake up and know CAD. It's something that's in baby steps. Yeah. And you have to do little things like learn, you know, the basics of, you know, making a box to a round thing, and then how to do threads and holes, and how to do, I love doing round stuff. I really like round, because round always has some really cool challenges and angles to it and stuff that are very unusual. And I find it's a challenge, and it's a lot of fun to do something. If somebody comes to me and they have something rounded and it has different shapes or whatever, but it's round, and they say, here, can you, you know, make me something like this, but, you know, make it a couple of changes and do it this way so that it will fit really well with my tool or whatever. I like sitting down and drawing that up. That always, you know, it's just intriguing. And it's when you get the drawing done, it's like, man, this is so cool. I'm going to put this on a 3D printer, and then it's going to be in my hand. You know, it's like that. It's wow. You know, it's just so cool. It's quite an event. But if you're interested in learning Autodesk Fusion and you've been struggling a little bit with it, maybe this book will help you out a lot. You know, for the price of it, I think it's dirt cheap. You know, just to be able to get something, even a reference manual like this, where you can look back and go, okay, I want to do something, and you know what, if I look in this book, maybe I can find it, figure it out, and how to do it, you know, because that's where I think a lot of times, that's where CAD software and stuff really sort of hits the wall on you sometimes, is you're trying to do something, and all of a sudden you realize, I've got a problem. How do I approach this problem to sketch it in so the 3D printer, whatever machine, will understand, this is what I'm built, this is what I want, you know, and sometimes that can come together with a book like this, where it helps you to figure out, okay, I know the steps I need to take in order to make this happen, or how to do it. It's just a very good thing. And I wanted to announce it this week as soon as possible. When the book was Jake and the Josh here, they sent me the book so I could have a look at it, and I was like, wow, this is really what's needed. In fact, I'll tell you what, I will be using this book and going through the exercises in it myself to just better learn CAD, because the better I learn CAD, the better I can do my drawings and the more comfortable I am. And I do like the challenge of sitting down and trying to draw something up. It is sometimes a little bit of a head-banging frustration thing, but at the same time, the results just make you feel so good inside when you think, yep, I got it. I got this, you know, the challenge. Challenge accepted, and I came and got it done. Well, if you've hung on this long, it's time to get to the good stuff. Yes, we're going to give away something. Yes, in fact, technically, I have a big meter from Teschmann that I really like. It's a multimeter. It's my kind of meter. So this one here came in with it, of course, and we were testing it and what have you, showing it on the show. And I think we should just, you know what, just unplug this thing and let's give it away. Okay, so how do we get in on that? Well, you're going to send an email over to CTrewards@gmx.com.
Yes.
And in the subject of the body of the email, Teshman. Okay? Yeah, that's the word. Yeah. Now, in the body of the email, just your name and address. That's it. And we'll make up little tickets from that and print them all up. We'll put them in the coffee jar. We'll pull out a wiener, and some wiener will get this one. Now, this one has the batteries already in it. Sorry about that, but yeah, this is the one that I already opened and got into it. Now, I did leave the screen protection cover on, so, you know, you got that going for you. And we'll send that all out to a lucky winner next week. Yeah, oh yeah. So, one entry per household, of course. And we'll see if we can get this back in the box, because, you know, once I finished opening a box, everything's never, you know, it never goes back in the box. It's never the same after that, but there we go. Well, okay, there it is. Okay, so multimeter from Teshman, like the one we just showed the other week, and this is just another one of those little ones, this programmable type thing that has what we call smart digital meter from Teshman. So pretty cool item. Meantime, let's thank everyone for watching Coffee and Tools, and please subscribe and ring the notice bell and share and whatever. I gotta get out of here. Over and out.